G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today it's time for video log number 6. I think I actually introed the last video log incorrectly, and I think I said 4 and it was number 5, so I'm not going to get that wrong again. I'm going to make sure I have the right video log in the intro. But I've got a bunch of letters over here, and I think it's time for a video log, so let's go through them and see what we got. Where's my letter opener? It's been good. I've been getting consistent mail, which has been lots of fun, from all over the world. This one's from Painter. So it might be your letter. You'd probably be able to tell your letter because you actually sealed it with those American flags there. But I've been getting stuff from all over. I've like had international letters from all over the place. Okay, there's lots of parts to this letter. Let's see. Dear Mr. Paladin, it's Max again. I have some more questions, so Max must have written before. I have a friend who likes being an engineer. Do you have any tips for him? I have a little series I did a while back called That Beeping Sentry. So check that out. It's got some pretty strong sentry gun spots, even though there was a change in the gunmetal update, I believe, to the way a lot of the engineer stuff worked. So be sure and check out other engineers like Uncle Dane. He's a very good sentry main, and just experience it. Try and work with your team, though. Being a rogue engineer tends to get you into trouble unless you know what you're doing, so yeah. Defense is easier to learn, too, on engineer. My brother is a scout main. Do you have any tips for him? Are we going to go through all the classes? Scout main, best advice for a scout main, don't be near any surfaces, because you don't want to be near any splash damage, so learn to jump off objects, learn to be away from any surfaces like walls and the ground whenever possible, and you'll survive things like soldiers for a lot longer. Get a good read on the situation. If it's not a good situation, just back out. How many hours a week do you spend recording videos? Just about all of it. I record near about everything. There's some things I don't record because I'm just being cash, but, you know, for the most part I record everything. I don't upload everything, though. You know, nobody wants to see everything. I mean, that'll get boring real fast. What is my opinion of the beta map Cactus Canyon? Haven't spent too much time on Cactus Canyon, so I don't really have an opinion on it yet. What's my favorite knife? That'll be the Black Rose. I put a professional killstreak kit on it. I like the look of it. And he's asking me to have a nice day. The other piece of paper has some fan art, so it looks like I read the best piece of paper first. How about that? What have we got here? Oh, okay, it's got the Mr. P. Remember before I said somebody did up the Mr. P and the P looked like a hand with a knife right there? That one. Ooh, I'm all backwards. I can't work in reverse. I've got to actually look at it. It's like looking in a mirror that's in a camera and it's getting me confused. But yeah, I thought that made a really good little logo last time. So is that Max's stuff? No, that was signed CB, so I don't think that's Max's artwork from before. Oh, okay, Mr. Paladin. Hi, this is Max's mum. Hi, Max's mum. I want to express my gratitude for the family-friendly nature of your channel. It is hard to find gamers who don't use bad language or make inappropriate commentary, and I appreciate that you are a clean YouTuber. In Christ Alone from Paige. Oh, thanks, Paige. That was really, really cool. I think that's the first letter I've ever got from a fan's parent. So yeah, I try and be family friendly. I mean, I've got my own family, I've got my own kids. I'm married, I'm old, so, you know, I tend to be appropriate in the most circumstances, because you never know when somebody's going to be recording and make it into a meme or something like that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you got to watch yourself. Besides, you want to have a good representation for yourself, because you never want to be like looking for a job later on and then someone say, you know, go to your social media and find all this garbage all over your social media when you're trying to apply for a job, even flipping burgers. I mean, if you have social media about all sorts of agendas and all sorts of craziness and all sorts of vulgarity, they're just going to pass you over for the next person who simply doesn't have that. That was unexpected. I like that. Someone said, I hope you showed this in the video. Put a smiley face on the back. A big old grin. I think it got a little bit smudged in transit. You know how when letters get sent, they just get fed through machines. Oh, cool, this is from Finland. From Hel It's got a Helsinki post stamp on it. I got fans all over, and it's really fun to get mail from all over. If you're in a weird part of the world, send me something. It's interesting. It's always it makes me curious. Let's see, what have we got here? Okay, this is from Waffle Jack, and it's from Finland. Let's see, it's hard to explain the scene, so I'll see if I can get it up here. It's got some busted windows. You've got blood on my suit, and I'm holding my weapon, so I've got my ambassador there with my black rose. Looks like I killed someone, but I'm disguised as a rainbow. I love it. That is hilarious. It looks like, okay, it's got to be a dead sniper because I see his hat and I see his kukri over there. Definitely. Why did I shoot him in the chest though instead of the headshot? I often like getting the headshots on the snipers just as a bit of comeuppance. I'm gonna have to put that one up. Let me put that to the side. I want the other artwork to the side as well. Oh, do you like the shirt? The missus got me the shirt. I don't need Google. My wife knows everything. I often tell people, you know, my Google foo is strong. If I need to look for something online, I can search it. And oftentimes with people's questions, because I get a ton of questions, so I often tell people, you know, this is the type of question that a Google search would answer. You know, I don't have to personally answer everything. I know people like the Mr. Paladin touch on everything, but it does not need to be my word on everything. Some things can just be Googled and the solution be found. Oh, cool. I like this. It's got a Georgia on it, so this is something local with a Mr. P on it to seal it up with. All personal like. I am loving this little letter opener that I got from one of you fellas. I like this printout. Hold on. Let me see if I can separate it from the other stuff. There's a paper clip here. I save paper clips. These things, I mean, they're good for just about everything, especially with old computers. I mean, ever since I used to have to pop CDs out of drives, I've saved paper clips because I also fidget a lot. I don't know if you've noticed that. I like to fidget my hands a lot. So while I'm talking, I'll often be messing around with a stress ball or something, or I'll tear apart paper clips all day long. But yeah, I got, first of all, got the classic spy with his laugh. That's what got me laughing a second ago. Oh, okay. Hello, Mr. Paladin. Can you please autograph my spy picture? You know what? I've never actually autographed Mr. Paladin on anything. I've autographed my name, but I don't think I've actually written, you know, Mr. Paladin on anything. I'm a huge fan of your YouTube channel, and my favorite class is TF2. Is a spy. I think you are the best spy, and I want your autograph. I enclosed a stamped envelope. Okay. I enclosed a stamped envelope. Wow, thought about this. Sincerely, Matthew. P.S. Your videos inspired and helped me to be a good spy. I am definitely going to do that for you, Matthew. Since you've gone out of your way to get everything in line, I have the stamped envelope here. I'll get that signed, and I'll sign it as Mr. Paladin. I will work out how my signature is even meant to look as it is. It's going to be my first signature. How about that? First time I've actually signed as Mr. Paladin. Because you guys don't want my real name signed, I'm sure. Actually, that's a good question. Should I sign it as my real name signature, or should I sign it as Mr. Paladin? I think you'd want it as Mr. Paladin. Okay, out of the same letter. Dear Mr. Paladin, you guys' handwriting is so nice looking. Hold on, first of all, I'll turn that around. You guys have such nice looking handwriting. My handwriting is horrible. Dear Mr. Paladin, I am a loyal fan and subscriber. I play Team Fortress 2 as a spy almost always. Your How a Spy Thinks and Trickstabs tutorial and all of your spy videos inspire me. Oh, I put a break there because I got caught because he said my spy videos inspire him, and I was just like, the word inspire seemed to have the word spy in it, and it just threw me for a moment. They inspire me to get better at TF2. Since I've been watching your videos, I have become better as a spy. My current loadout is Diamondback, Red Tape Recorder, the Dead Ringer, or the Cloak and Dagger. And the Blitzkrieg Butterfly Knife, or sometimes the Kunai. I hope someday to be as good as you... I use a Red Tape Recorder there. I hope to someday be as good at TF2 as you. I also like your intro, G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and your closing, I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Sincerely, Matthew or Mr. Flipper. P.S. I think you are the best spy in TF2, so I drew you this picture. I hope to meet you one day. Okay, cool. Let me see if I can show that. That was just a small... Oh, hell, it's out of focus a little. A small spy picture at the bottom with the striped pin suit. You know something I didn't get used to doing when I was in school with art is I never really got the hang of doing people's faces because the face looks really silly. You know, your eyes are in the middle, and I could do like still life. I could draw like a landscape and stuff all day long, but I could never get people's faces down, and it really spoiled art for me because I never could, you know, every time I drew something, it never seemed to look right to me. Okay, so that's that. I've got to make sure, let me put this to the side where I've got to sign this picture. And I'll put this with my other letters and the other with the art. Okay. See, I've got to keep organized. I'm really bad. My memory's not too good. And I know it. So if I don't keep things organized, I will forget things at the drop of a hat. Like, I'll be going a week and then I'll get a phone call. Hey, I've got to get to an appointment or something because I just forgot it, unless I throw it on my calendar or something like that. Let's see, this one is from Memphis, Tennessee. I've been up to Memphis. I went to, when my parents came over on a visit, my mom used to be a big Elvis fan, so we ended up going up there to visit that, and it was actually real interesting. I got more out of that trip and learning stuff about what happened with Elvis and all that kind of stuff, because that was my mom's world, you know. I never experienced that. You know, I had my own, I wouldn't say heroes, but, you know, music idols when I was growing up, and it definitely didn't include Elvis at the time. But I could appreciate it. I mean, it was a really interesting trip. Okay, somebody said, I told you I would draw a Your Eternal Reward, so here it is. And it was from... Radio, I don't know, is that two G's or is that a Y and a G? I'm not sure. Sorry if I've said your name wrong. But there you go. That's a Your Eternal Reward that is blood-tipped and etched with my Mr. Paladin. I like it. Actually, I'm just looking at what else is on the hilt there. Is that meant to be VV or is that... I never noticed the Your Eternal Reward. Does it have something particular on its on the top of the hilt? See, I know what I'm talking about is right there. He got something. See something. See, it's out of focus today. Something written there, and I'm wondering if that's actually a part of the knife or not, or if it was like a little Easter egg put in there. Man, I like getting stuff. I like stuff. It's like Christmas, you know. I'm just opening fun stuff, and it's very entertaining to me to be getting this stuff. Oh, I hate doing that. Did you see what I just did? I stuck my tongue out. My brother, when he was thinking all the time, he would think with his tongue out all the time. It was almost funny. Of course, you know, being my brother, I had to make fun of it, you know. He was my younger brother after we were all... Do you guys have siblings? Lots of siblings out there? I think it's an older brother's duty to make fun of their younger brother. Dear Mr. Paladin, thanks for the videos on how a spy thinks, and etc. Fuse all the tips. Oh, hold on. I've got to read this carefully. Fuse all of the tips on the classes, and it helped me at Sniper, Spy, Pyro, and Scout. I watch all your videos every time one is uploaded, and the name of it is Fire Archer. I'm not sure the name of it is Fire Archer. Mr. Paladin, I have one question. Please don't read it out loud. Here it goes. Okay. Well, I won't read it out loud. Okay. I read your question, and here is your odd. I like it. It's very stylized. Here we go. We got me as a spy. I'm chasing down a pyro with the rubber glove on his head, and it's quite obviously a balloonicorn there. And he's going after the payload, and it's on its way to red, but I am not going to let that happen. I've clearly got the jump on this pyro. He is not going to expect a stab, and it's going to be going down. I'm going to be getting that pyro no problem at all. Love it. And last letter. I'm on the last letter of today. Wow, this one was printed out on the address too. It's nice and clear. This one comes from Texas. From Lantana, Texas. Is that how you say it? Lantana? Lantana. Lantana was a plant in Australia. It was kind of a weed. I don't know. It attracted a lot of butterflies, but it was really hard to get rid of if it got planted in an area, and it had like thorns in it. I don't know if it's the same Lantana that's over here in the United States or not. Someone will have to let me know. Dear Mr. Paladin, I have seen most, if not all, of your videos from when you used to play with Mr. Spirit all the time. That was a long time ago. I haven't seen Spirit in a while. He kind of took a little hiatus, and I'll have to touch base with him, see how he's going, especially after the weather warms up. You know, as it gets into summer, I might take a trip up to Canada and go see him. I just want to say that you are one of the greatest TF2 spies that I've seen, and also I like that you appeal to all audience by also playing Soldier and Pyro. Yeah, I play other classes, you know. I just enjoy Spy most, but I'll play whatever the team needs. I haven't been here from the beginning, but I've seen your channel grow, and you deserve it. You are great at what you do as a spy main, and you have inspired me to keep on trying no matter how many times I fail, and that's a big thing. It's what you do with yourself when things don't go right that's important. I mean, you're gonna fail. I've failed more times than I've succeeded. I mean, what was that? I think I already did that quote from Michael Jordan the other time. He's missed more shots than he's ever done. In fact, he's missed many clutch shots, but you know, he's a good player and he's played a lot, and that gives him the opportunity to make the good shots. Thank you for your contribution to the Team Fortress community, and I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. This was for a class at school, so that's why it's all formal. Oh, okay, so that's why he did it all printed out. He actually had to write a letter as a part of a school assignment. That's so cool. That's interesting that the schools assign stuff like that, because, you know, people don't write letters anymore. It's all email, it's all text, it's all social media. You don't have that touch of sending someone a letter anymore. So sending someone a formal letter where everything is correct and everything is laid out correctly, it's getting to be rare. I mean, that's half of the fun of receiving these letters, is that it's not usual. It's not my everyday thing anymore. My everyday thing is I come on, I log on to Steam, I see who's around, I jump on the TeamSpeak, I check messages from all over. I get like hundreds of YouTube messages, and that's why I can't respond to them all, because there's just so many of them these days. And I like Twitter, the social media, because that allows a lot of interaction. But yeah, writing a letter out to someone, typing it out, putting all the formal addresses in all the right places, it's just not done much anymore. The most you get in the mail these days is when you order something online. And speaking of, I want to order stuff for behind me. I want to get like a poster up over here and some other stuff. I want to get something. I want to get some of the other characters to go along with this little guy who got sent to me. You know, it's all fun. I like having fun. I like buying stuff. I like getting stuff. I like receiving stuff. I like stuff that comes in the mail, and I like the letters. So thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Did I just say my own outro wrong? What am I doing? Am I? Oh. I need some more Mountain Dew. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.